Hi, I'm Chad, and if you're a commercial real estate investor or involved in the industry in any capacity, this video will make you better at what you do. I know that's a bold claim, but give me a chance to show you why discounted cash flow analysis is such an important topic. Let's jump into it by first covering the most basic measure of estimating the value of a building, which is the income capitalization method. Also known as the cap rate method, the principle is very straightforward. The income of a property is capitalized by the prevailing market cap rate to derive the value. Described even more simply, income is divided by a cap rate to calculate the value. Here's an example. A property has net operating income of $140,000 and the cap rate is 7%. Dividing $140,000 by 7% produces a value of $2 million. And a quick tip, if you take the reciprocal of the cap rate, that is divide 1 by the cap rate, you'll get a multiplier. So quick math again, if you have a 7% cap rate, take 1, divide it by 7%, you'll get 14.28. For every dollar of NOI, the building will theoretically be worth $14.28. If you have $100,000 in NOI, the building's value can now be estimated at $1.428 million. You can streamline this even further and even ignore the size of the building momentarily. If a property's lease rate is $10 per square foot, the property is worth $148.23 per square foot using a 7% cap rate. This back-of-the-envelope math is usually the first step that an investor will do, but there are more sophisticated techniques available as well. Enter discounted cash flow analysis. It's not a uniquely commercial real estate term by any means, and in fact, it's one of the cornerstone calculations of finance in general. The premise of discounting is that a dollar today is worth more than a dollar in the future. Intuitively, this makes sense, since there's a risk that you don't actually get the dollar in the future versus the certainty of having it today. This is the foundation of discounting. You simply reduce future cash flows based on the length of time you expect to receive those cash flows at a rate you feel accounts for the risk of receiving them. Appropriately, this new risk-adjusted number is called the present value. You can take a single number in the future and discount it to a present value, or you can take a series of cash flows and discount them all to a present value. As you can envision, this is exactly what we'll be doing with real estate analysis that has several years of rental income to account for. If we're doing a 5-year analysis, as an example, we'll discount all the future cash flows back to a present value. The formula looks a bit daunting, but if you use a program like Excel, you can calculate this quite quickly. Let's jump over to Excel and I'll show you how. I'd encourage you to take a minute or two and enter these values into a spreadsheet of your own so you can follow along. This is a very simple example where I took the gross revenue and deducted operating expenses to get the net operating income, or NOI. We'll just assume it's a 5-year period, but this analysis can essentially be over any period. So we can discount each year's net operating income by using the PV formula in Excel. I'll just enter present value in here. We're going to calculate the present value for each individual year. So the formula is equal PV bracket. Then you want to take the discount rate, which I'll click on here so we have a reference to it. Then comma. Then the amount of years that we're going to be discounting this by, which I'll click up here, which is 1. This will carry over as we go through years 1 through 5. Then an extra comma, because we don't have any payments that we're making in this particular example, followed by the number that we're actually going to be discounting, which is the net operating income, then close the bracket. You'll see this gives a negative number, which for the purposes of this illustration, I'm going to convert this to be a positive number. It will make more sense when I show you the net present value calculation shortly, but just enter a negative before PV. Now return a positive number. I'll explain discount rates in more detail shortly, but for now, just realize that the higher the discount rate is, the more it will lower the future amount to today's value. If you use 0% discount rate, the number in the future will be the same as the present value. But as that discount rate increases, the present value decreases. One more thing we can do is we can anchor the discount rate on here so that when we pull this formula over, it'll automatically calculate it. So if we go to cell C7, which is where the discount rate is, just enter a dollar sign before C7. That will anchor that column. And then if we select it and drag it all the way over, that will give us the present values for each one of those cash flows. As you could see, because we're discounting year 5 over 5 years, the number is less than the years previously. And the good part about having these cells referenced is that we can actually go and change these discount rates. So as I mentioned earlier, if we have a zero discount rate, that's essentially not discounting the numbers at all. So all those future values will be the exact same as they are in today's dollars. As we increase this, as we go to 5%, you could see that those numbers become less. As we go to 10%, even less, and so on. So if you set it up this way, you can make adjustments to the discount rate and it'll automatically recalculate your present values. But let's go back to 8% on this. And then what we'll do is we'll actually add another simple formula to sum all the present values. And quite simply, it's just equals sum. We'll drag across here, close the bracket. That's the sum of our present values. I'll come back to this number shortly, but if you're following along so far, getting to net present value will come next. Net present value is simply the sum of all the positive and negative discounted cash flows. To get that, we just need to add the purchase price and the forecasted sale price. So going back to our Excel spreadsheet. So I don't want to delete the formulas in these cells, so I'm just going to copy and paste this below. And then the next thing we can do is we can add in a purchase price and we could add in a selling price. So let's just add $1 million for the purchase price, and we'll add 1.1 million for a sale price. And because the purchase price is a cash outflow, we need to make that number negative. And then we also need to account for the selling price. So we can just add it to the end of year five, come up to the formula here and add in this cell. So that now that takes into account year five's NOI plus the selling price. To keep this example simple, I'm assuming there aren't any debt or tax considerations, and I'm also ignoring any costs associated with leasing any vacancies. And I'm also setting the selling value arbitrarily. Also, the default formula implies that cash flows are received at the end of the period, so further micro adjustments might need to be made. As you can appreciate, there's a lot that goes into formulating all these additional considerations, so I'm just trying to get you familiar with the concept with this simple example. To calculate the net present value in Excel, the formula is as follows. It's equals NPV bracket, take the discount rate. Then we want to take the series of cash flows, not including the purchase price. We're going to add that in right after. But when you're accounting for the cash flows, we can just take the range, close that bracket. Now we can add back in the purchase price. And now we have our net present value. So now that we have the net present value, the beauty of this is that we can come back up to our original example and calculate it the long way just to show you how this all works. So let's come back in. We'll take our year five cash flow and we got to add back in this selling price. So I'm just going to manually enter this right now. This automatically recalculates because we have formulas in there. This shows you the sum of the present values. So this was doing this all individual years. If we take net present value again, and we just take the sum of the cash flows. This is what net present value is. We take the sum of the cash flows, subtract the purchase price. And again, I'll just enter this in manually as $1 million. You can see the net present value is exactly the same. So this emphasizes the net present value is simply the total of all the discounted cash flows. And in a real estate context, that's your purchase price, all your cash flows over the duration of the holding period, and the sale price at the end. Here's what the net present value represents. If the number is positive, the expected performance of the property will exceed the discount rate, which you could consider a hurdle rate in this context, and you should proceed with the investment at least theoretically. If the number is negative, the investment will not clear your hurdle rate and you should pass on the opportunity. Now, there are many reasons to proceed or not proceed, irrespective of what the net present value reveals, but it provides a helpful signal nonetheless. One major question that might be percolating for you, what do you use as a discount rate? I've seen numerous formulas on how to calculate the rate, but some of these formulas run the risk of being too academic to be useful in actual practice. So without overcomplicating it, here are two simple methods. First, take a safe rate, which could be a 10-year treasury bill or anything else that you deem appropriate, and add a premium that you feel would be necessary for the particular property. An older property with unstable income might need a higher premium, whereas a great property with a strong tenant might need less. Second, simply determine what rate you want to earn from the property. Or stated another way, this is the rate of return you would want to earn from a comparable investment with similar types of risks. If you expect a 10% compounded yearly return, use 10% as your discount rate. This leads to the internal rate of return, which is very closely related. The internal rate of return, or IRR, is the average annual return on equity over the holding period of the investment. You're probably familiar with the term return on equity, or ROE, and the internal rate of return is precisely the ROE if the timeline of ownership is exactly 1 year. Since a real estate investment is often much longer, we use the term IRR instead. Excel can calculate IRR very quickly, which I'll show you right away. But first, if you're getting any value from this, I'd greatly appreciate you subscribing to my channel. It helps me out a lot. Now, to get the IRR, the internal rate of return, let's copy and paste this section again. Bring it down here. Then I'm going to just enter a new row of data so that we can easily set up the IRR formula. So first thing we'll do, we'll enter in the purchase price again. So I'm just going to reference it from up here. And then I'm just going to pull down all of these net operating income values and pull this over. And again, we need to account for the sale price up here. So we're just going to come in and we'll add this in here. So now we've got all the cash flows, including the purchase price. For the internal rate of return formula, you want to make sure that you're actually including the purchase price when you're doing this formula. So the formula is IRR bracket, take all of the cash flows, including the purchase price, close your bracket, and you've got your internal rate of return. And we can increase this by some decimal places to get a more accurate number. So the next thing I want to show you is that the internal rate of return and the net present value are actually connected. And if we take the net present value and we use that as the discount rate, that's the exact discount rate where the net present value will be equal to zero. And since we set this up with formulas, we can actually enter this in up here the exact same way. So I'll do 12.5128. I'm just entering that as a percentage because we have this set up as a percentage cell. And if we click enter, you'll see that net present value is essentially zero. If we had a few more numbers to round in there, it would be zero. But for all intents and purposes, you can see that the internal rate of return is the discount rate where the net present value is equal to zero. I hope this gives you some insight into discounted cash flow analysis and the amazing potential it has in analyzing investment opportunities. I have to stress though that this is a very simplified example and doesn't take into account amortization of the mortgage nor any of the costs of leasing vacancies. Furthermore, it doesn't account for any tax implications or debt, so you could really call this particular example a before-tax NPV or IRR analysis. Also recognize I'm trying to condense a lot of information to a short video, so I'm just scratching the surface here. When I first learned about this concept, the one light bulb moment for me was that I didn't know what I didn't know. I don't expect you to become an expert on the topic after watching this video, but I hope it sparks a fire in you to learn more about it. If you're interested in exploring it further, there are a couple of places I can recommend. The first is the CCIM Institute, which has a series of courses about discount and cash flow analysis. The program is expensive though, so if you're not interested in pursuing the CCIM designation, I would steer you towards REFM, which is an excellent program at a fraction of the cost. I'll put links to both of them in the description below. I have two more topics to cover in this series about investing in industrial real estate. The next two videos will cover 10 traits I've observed in all successful commercial real estate investors. Following that video, I'm going to provide a free checklist you can use when exploring industrial real estate properties. If this video helped you out at all, please hit that like button below. It would mean a lot to me. And thanks for watching. Have a great day.